The DSM-5 diagnostic criteria for anorexia include 1. Restriction of energy intake resulting in significantly low body weight, taking into context the individual patient's age, sex, and previous growth trajectory. There is intentionally no strict cutoff for significantly low weight, meaning your clinical judgment is important. Some adult studies use 17 kgs per meter squared or 18.5 kgs per meter squared. 2. An intense fear of gaining weight or being fat, or persistent behavior that interferes with weight gain. 3. A disturbance in the way the patient experiences their own weight or shape, or excessive influence of weight and shape in self-evaluation, or a lack of recognition of the seriousness of their current low weight. Anorexia nervosa can be categorized into either restricting caloric intake or binging and purging. Purging can refer to vomiting or using diuretics or laxatives to prevent weight gain. Get a history of the patient's highest and lowest weights, a diet history, exercise history, and assess for other psychological or psychiatric symptoms such as anxiety, depression, suicidal ideation, and substance use. Physical signs primarily result from malnutrition, which can affect all organ systems. When doing a physical exam, pay attention to vital signs, as you may see bradycardia, orthostatic heart rate and blood pressure changes, and/or hypothermia. Plot the patient's height, weight, and BMI, and compare to their historical growth curves to help determine the degree of malnutrition. Other exam signs include: evaluate mucous membranes for dehydration and teeth for dental erosion from vomiting. Look for bradycardia and arrhythmias. Look for masses or organomegaly. It is very common to have hypoactive bowel sounds and constipation with malnutrition. Lanugo, Russell's sign, which is callousing of the dorsal hand or fingers from self-induced vomiting, and signs of self-injurious behavior. Tanner stage them. Do a complete fundoscopic exam, as elevated intracranial pressure can cause loss of appetite. Treatment should include medical monitoring, nutrition counseling, and psychological support. In cases of severe malnutrition, inpatient admission for medical stabilization may be necessary. Criteria for admission include a weight less than 75% of their expected body weight, bradycardia with a heart rate of less than 50 beats per minute, systolic blood pressure of less than 90 millimeters of mercury, orthostatic hypotension, a temperature of less than 96 degrees Fahrenheit, acute food refusal, or severe electrolyte abnormalities. Suicidality requires psychiatric hospitalization.